evidence of things that God said, right? Evidence of things that God said, although you don't see it. Is that right? That's what faith does. Faith let God do what he said to do. Yeah? Is that all right with you all? Now let's go. So let's go to the sixth verse, and we're going to go to Brother Wiley. Even as Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him, or accounted to him, heaven said, for righteousness. Know ye therefore that they which are what? The same or what? Absolutely. You need to highlight that. But that's the fourth chapter too. That's the finish, that's the rest of this. If you are, what is it? Know ye therefore that they which are of faith, faith people, are children of Abraham, right? Guess what? Abraham believed God before a law came from Mount Sinai. Is that right? Law come how many years later? How many years later did law come after Abraham?
Amen.
Well, Abraham believed in God gonna raise him up from the dead.
That's a little sticky, but I'm trying to get somewhere with you. Are you all here? That's a little sticky. There's a couple schools to talk, but we're trying to get someplace. Oh, Jesus. What verse is it? 11th verse? But that, okay. And the law is not of faith, all that stuff. Now, everybody say, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made what? That we might receive. That's right. We might receive promise. Now, you know, redemption is like this here. You know, since we're in class, do you all remember the Book of Ruth a little bit? Huh?
Amen.
The Book of Ruth. Here's where redemption was. You remember the Book of Ruth? How many of y'all remember read a little bit of the Book of Ruth, right? Huh? Well, Ruth had a mother-in-law named Naomi, right?
Right.
Huh?
Right.
Well, what was her husband's name? Emily?
No.
Naomi's husband left Israel and went to Moabites. Stayed for 10 years, right? Naomi's husband died, right? And Naomi had two sons. I can't call their name, but Kilion. Anyway, both of them died too, right?
Right.
They both died. Here's the way redemption works. You understand redemption by reading the Book of Ruth. So when you see that word redemption, since we invite the study, I'm going to clear that up for you. Is that all right?
Amen.
So here's the way redemption works. Naomi comes back to Israel, right?
Right.
Huh? After 10 years, she comes back bitter because her husband dead, her son's dead, right? Her daughter-in-law comes back with her, right?
Right.
Huh? Yeah. She's poor. Guess what? She don't have no land. It's been mortgaged. Right?
Right.
She don't have no land. Naomi don't have no land. Naomi's poor. She have a daughter-in-law. Well, you know what the daughter-in-law said? I'm going to go out and get some food for us and glean behind the reapers. You know why you can't? You know why you can't reap with the reapers? You don't have no land, don't you? Your land is gone. Your land been sold. Right? So Ruth says she can go and glean behind the reapers. You know what gleaning means? You hit the leftovers. Are you there? You can't get the cream of the crop. You glean, you get for the left.
That's
right. So Naomi, Ruth is going to get to glean behind the reapers. Guess what? Yeah. Boaz saw her, inquired of her. Right? Hmm. He inquired from his servant, who is this damsel? Oh, she came back with Naomi, her mother-in-law, right? She came back to Judea, came back to Israel with her. They've been gone for 10 years in the Moabite country. You know who Moabites are? They're heathens. Right? Moabites fought Israel. Moabites are descendants of incest. Right? Ammon and Moab are descendants from incest. It comes from Lot. Are you with me? Huh? So really, it's almost a curse on Naomi now. Are you with me? Huh? She don't have no land. Israel was allotted their land. By tribes, right? Everybody was allotted their land. You don't have no land. You've been gone. Your husband must have marked his land, sold his land. And guess what? You got to be bought back. So Boaz sees this damsel, right? Well, who is she? Well, she's a daughter-in-law of Naomi. So Boaz said, don't just let her glean, let her reap with the reapers. Let her get some of the best, let her get some of the cream of the crop. Guess what? She went and told her mother-in-law. Right?
Right?
How she found favor in the eyes of this man, Boaz. Right? Got a wise mother-in-law, right?
Right.
So So that, so Naaman knew Boaz is. That's your cousin. Are you with me? He's wealthy. He's your cousin. They got a factory down at the thirsty floor. You need to get out to the thirsty floor. You need to find faith in the man dying.
Is that right? Go and uncover and speak.
Are you all with me?
You ain't seen exposing herself by uncovering and speak.
She's letting him know that Naomi is her heir. And we are your people. You have a right to redeem us. Are you with me?
Right.
You can buy us back.
Are you with me?
Right.
That's what redemption is about. So that's what Boaz did. Boaz went came before the elders in the gate and told the people, who else here that's closer to Naomi than I am? So ain't nobody closer to Naomi than you are. You got a right to redeem me. He liked it anyway, so he redeemed him. Bought the land back. Bought the land back, so he got the land back, then they got on your own. Are y'all with me? If that's what redemption is. Redemption comes from a kinsman. Are y'all there?
Yes.
You had to be a kinsman to redeem. Where Boaz was there was that kinsman. And so anyway, that's a long, long, to make a long story short. That's what redemption meant. Guess what? Jesus was our kinsman.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Yeah, it's right. Believe it or not. Jesus was made like you are, so he could redeem you. Is that right?
Amen.
That's why the Bible says, What was that word? Redemption is to turn up to redeem. You just wear it in 13, but Christ has what? Redeemed us, right? From the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. That's redemption. And that makes it more clear when you get to the fourth chapter. You really find out how redemption works in the fourth chapter. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Are you all back? Let's clear this up with my wife thing. If faith is credited to a man 430 years before the law came, then there's got to be a purpose for the law. Huh? If righteousness comes through faith, right? Then the example was Abraham was made right. So if righteousness comes through faith, are y'all with me? Huh? Then what was the purpose of the law? I'm asking a question.
Just to know right from wrong.
Okay, Dr. Taylor?
It was a schoolmaster or tutor. You know, it was actually to show you your sins for real.
Okay.
Because you.
Well, that's good. The law, a good way to say the law is sin, a good way to see what the law is like James said. Law show you the kind of dirt on your face. But guess what? The law can't take the dirt off your face. Right?
Amen.
It's like a mirror. A law shows you that you need help. Law shows you that you sin. Right? That's where you get the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt not. And thou shalt not. And thou shalt not. When you get through saying thou shalt not, you're going to say, "Ooh, Lord. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not bear false witness. Thou shalt not commit adultery." Ooh, Jesus. Right?
Amen. No will.
So a lot of people want to know that the only way to the devil's head, because more likely, all of us in here have broke the law.
Amen.
Right? Mm-hmm. All of us in here have more than likely everybody broke the law. Is that right? If you bear false witness, you're broke the law. If you're guilty of one part, you're a transgressor. Is that what James said? Huh? I'm listening.
Pastor, can I read?
Okay. All right.
Maybe I'm
moving too fast.
No, you're not. In Galatians 3:24, So the law was, this is the NIV version.
I'm listening.
So the law was put in charge to lead us to Christ, that we might be justified by faith. Now that faith has come, we are no longer under the supervision of the law.
Okay, let's get down to it, brother. We want to turn every stone that needs to be turned. Is that all right?
Yes, sir.
Every stone that needs to be turned. We want to turn it. The issue is, my wives, first two chapters, 1 and 2, the Apostle Paul is defending his apostleship.
Amen.
Are you all in agreement with that?
Amen.
I said the first two chapters, I wrote it down somewhere. The Apostle Paul is defending his apostleship, right?
Amen.
It's necessary that he defend his apostleship because he wasn't one of the twelve. Is that right? So he had to defend his apostleship. He wasn't one of the 12. Are you all with me? So that's what the first 1 and 2 chapters is about. He defends his gospel. Now, Mother Wiley, I just outlined it, but I didn't do it like this. Three and four, and Brother Corn, Brother Cannon is saying, 3 and 4, he explains, the gospel is explained. Would you ever say the gospel is explained? Third chapter and the fourth chapter, the gospel is explained. First chapter, the gospel is defended along with his apostleship. Right? That's why you see him. That's why when he started off to this Galatian, he's a Gentile people. Now, you really authorized to preach to us? Look how he said, Paul, an apostle, but do not want to dwell. Heaven said, not a man, neither by man, but by Jesus Christ, and God the Father, who raised him, right? Are y'all with me? So he defended his apostleship. And then after he defends his apostleship, he really defends his gospel that he preaches. Don't let nobody tell you that what I'm preaching to you is not pure, it's not from God. Do you see that in the 6th through the 9th verse? I marvel that ye so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ. Unto another gospel, right? Which is not enough. But there be some that trouble you, he's a Judaizer, right? And would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other what? Unto you, that the one that we have preached unto you, let it be what? In other words, I done preached to y'all and I done preached the truth to you. Anybody else come and tell you anything else? It's a lie. Right? And as we have said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that which you have received, let him be a what? That's right. Now you got to remember, these are Gentile people. Let me see something else in there. So, Brother Cannon.
Yes, sir.
I'm moving fast. What I'm really trying to do is scan three different chapters. Real fast, good time to do it. go on to this third chapter, y'all, because I'm in the midst. And
Consequence of sin. And death by sin,
King. Sin was still in the world. Sin was in the world before the law came. Right? And what happened? Nevertheless. You got it. I'll call up this man and say, nevertheless. Would you say it again? Nevertheless. Now, sin is not imputed where there is no law, but heaven said, nevertheless. Death still reigns. You know why death reigns? Because people were sinning. And people died as a consequence of their sin. Whether they knew they were sinners or not. Right? Yeah. Heaven said, nevertheless, death reigned from Adam all the way up to Moses. Law came through Moses, but people were still dying from Adam all the way up to Moses. And guess what? They died. How? Why? Really?
Even over them that had not
sinned
after the similitude.
They died, although they had done what Adam did. Heaven said, they died. God didn't tell them not to eat or to drink. They still died.
Amen.
They died. How do you say that? Read what he said. Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those that didn't sin after the similitude of Adam's transgression. In other words, they didn't have a commandment so much, but they still died, right? And the reason they died was because they were sinners. Everybody born in sin. And people died as a consequence of sin before the law came. So what was the purpose of the law? The purpose of the law is the law can't save nobody. The law is like a mirror that shows you that you have dirt on your face. But the law can't take the dirt off your face. Right? So what was the purpose of the law? Say it was added because of transgression. It's a schoolmaster. What you do in school, you learn things, right? Through the law, you're going to read this scripture also. Heaven said, through the law, you had to find that. Through the law is the knowledge of sin. Is that right? The law came to make sin look real bad. The law is holy. The law is righteous. But the law is not sin. But the law will show sin up in people, right? Huh? So that's why the Paul's about to call it administration of death. He still made that number seven, but he can't do nothing about it. Right? Can't change it. He can't make it better. Is that right? Is anybody here?
Yes.
Why don't you say yes?
Yes.